I just want to find a job to do and just fade away. Hi, my name is Chris. I'm 41 this year and I'm an owner of a funeral business in Singapore. What I do is I handle every aspect of a funeral. I take care of everything from collection of the body to the embalming, the decedent care as we call it, to the setting up of the funeral wake according to their religious or traditional and cultural rites, and I ensure that everything goes on without a hitch. Bit of OCD, so I need to make sure that everything runs perfectly, and I also believe that being there for the family all the time, visiting the wakes every day, sometimes even twice, they can put their mind to ease, and as well as mine, to make sure that I haven't left anything out. I wasn't in the funeral industry at all, never thought about it. I was in a totally different industry. I lost everything, I had to start from scratch. After a while, I couldn't find a job to do. I just wanted to find a job to do and just fade away, just disappear. I was at a very low point in my life. So I chanced upon funeral assistant. Thought that this would be, you know, as shitty as a job I can find. Didn't expect it that, you know, I lasted so long and made a career out of it. Yes, I've lost about maybe 40% of my friends. But then again, when something happens in the family and they need my services, they still do call me. It's just that we don't hang out. I realize that there's so much to learn. It's very fast paced. Families rely on us to help them through possibly the worst day of their lives. And that is where I start to see things differently. It's a very stigmatized job. There's a lot of taboo around it. And it's considered dirty work. But after actually doing the work, you realize that there's a lot of work satisfaction. Helping the families through their grief. I come to find it that, you know, it's actually where we're doing a very important job. And the fact that not many people will choose to do this, and that actually helped me to get out of my really low point in my life. One of the jobs that I did, the deceased was a developer. Massive funeral tentage, fully covered up, fully air-conditioned. Food service is push carts with the chef. So one stall does satay, one stall does laksa, one stall does chicken rice. This one they requested like jet plane, ship, mansion, mahjong table, anything that you can think of, and anything that I can get the craftsman to make within that period of time, you know, in time for the burning on the final night. So that's probably one of the more, you say, memorable ones. You know, it's a lot of work. I always take care of the deceased first. To me, that's my client. Sounds strange, but through the years that I've done this and followed this rule, I've been blessed that my funerals go rather smoothly. The best part of my job would be at the end of the day, when the family appreciates what you've done. Just a simple thank you for making sure that everything is done nicely, smoothly. That is by itself the greatest reward. Worst part of the job would be dealing with the grief. I've not been desensitized. I think perhaps that what makes me still efficient, effective in my line of work. So I absorb a lot of their emotions, which is actually not very healthy. You need to learn how to pull yourself out of it, but I just can't seem to do it. No, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with people who are desensitized and use it just, you know, just as a job, make sure it's done properly. Nothing wrong with that at all. It's just that for me, I do it with emotions. I come from the place where emotionally I'm involved. Some family members, they don't talk. So we have to understand that, okay, that's grief. You know, we need to see if we can help it along a bit. Some are, you know, they're generally angry during the duration of the wake. So we need to understand that they're grieving. Work-life balance is very tough in our line of work. So our partners and our family members have to be very understanding. When the call comes in, I make sure that I'm there within the hour, regardless the time of the day. What keeps me going is, apart from the fact that I need to work to put food on the table, the job satisfaction, I think, is a huge defining factor
for why I continue to do what I do.
I definitely would like to continue to do this for as long as I can. I'm Chris, a funeral director, and this is why I do what I do.